and the LXQT 0.17 desktop environment was launched with a series of discrete improvements. Check out what's new and see how to install on Linux. LXQT is one of the most recent open source desktop environments and also the successor to LXDE. LXQT is the result of the merger between the LXDE QT and Razer QT projects. It is a lightweight, modular, superfast, and easy to use desktop environment. This environment is a good option for those who do not want to stay at Unity or GNOME or want to experience new airs. LXQT uses the OpenBox Window Manager, the PCMan FM QT File Manager, which is a port in PCMan FM's QT port, the Razer Panel Desktop Panel, as well as other QT items such as its core components. It is also the lightweight desktop used by operating systems that are not looking for a lot of customization or productivity options but are focused on performance. Now, for LXQT fans or those still looking for a light and pleasant QTify desktop, LXQT 0.17 is the latest version of this open source desktop environment. In addition, LXQT 0.17 is the first upgrade for this desktop environment for 2021. What's new in LXQT 0.17? Arriving more than 5 months after LXQT 0.16.0. The launch of LXQT 0.17.0 is here to add an option to the panel to make it work as a dock, automatically hiding when it overlaps a window, adding support complete for file creation times in the file manager, as well as add support for non-LXQT applications to save your latest settings when the session ends. In addition, LXQT 0.17.0 adds separate inactive observers for AC and battery to power manager, allows users to create launchers from the file manager tools menu, improves support for SVG icon sets, improves opening a selection mixed file with different MIME types, and adds natural keyboard navigation on the desktop. Also improved in this version is QT Terminal Terminal Emulator, which now features 5 modes for wallpapers and a new option for disabling the college mode with brackets. The LX Image QT Manager Viewer, which presents thumbnail options in the preference dialog box, as well as the LXQT Archiver File Manager, which can now open or extract disk images, remembers the window settings, and offers a side panel with horizontal scrolling. Among other noteworthy changes included in LXQT 0.17.0, there is the addition of the Xterm Terminal Emulator as a runtime dependency, support for handling the notification summary as plain text, and a correction for a failure that occurred when displaying the QPS window if the application is started minimized to the system tray. Of course, there are several other small improvements and bug fixes to make LXQT more stable and reliable. Regarding the release of LXQT 0.16 last November, version 0.17 brings a number of improvements, but nothing too shocking or original, with many of the features already found on other Linux desktops. Among the highlights of the LXQT 0.17 are: Number 1. LXQT will end all child processes when exiting the session. Number 2. The LXQT File Manager supports the display of file creation blocks when run on supported kernels or file systems. Number 3. Better handling of the SVG icon. Number 4. The LXQT panel can now behave like a dog, that is, automatically hide a panel when it overlaps a window. Number 5. Improved keyboard navigation on the desktop. Number 6. LXQT power management now has an option to disable the inactive observer when the active window is in full screen mode. Number 7. LXQT Archiver now supports opening and extracting disk images. How to install or update LXQT? LXQT 0.17.0 is now officially available, but at the time of making this video, it is only in code form. Interested users can download it from official website. In the coming weeks, operating systems using this desktop will start adding the new version as an update, as long as their philosophy allows it. On operating systems like Lubuntu, you will have to wait at least until the release of Lubuntu 21.04 Hashit Hippo, which will take place on April 22, 2021. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the thumbs up button. It helps make a good content for you. Other than that, I'll see you in tomorrow's video. Peace out.